Hello everyone, my name is Monty Ashton from Dreamvision Creations. Thank you for joining me on this newest tutorial on how to finish the ears on your skull canine hood. We're going to start off by going over a bunch of the materials you'll need to start this project. Also going over the pattern that I have designed here. Some of the first things to start off with is got your slicker brush so you can brush out your seams and your fur. If you cut fur like this, it's going to have a lot of like loose hair on it, so it just helps to brush it out. A pair of scissors for cutting your edges. We're going to start off with going over the materials and tools you'll need for this part of the project. You'll first need your ear shapes that you already have made, whether it be made out of floss shape like this or flex foam ears you buy from DVC or from other companies online. You need your fur pattern pieces already cut out and ready to go. So we have three different colors here. We've got the gray, the black, and the frosted gray. And we also have a smooth minky fabric we'll be using for the inner ear sections. Then you'll need a pair of scissors for cutting off your edges once you sew things together, trimming up. Slicker brush in order to brush out your fur. What I usually like to do is I preemptively brush these out before I start sewing just to help remove any of the loose hairs. And also helps to brush out the seams before you start shaving. You'll need either Wonder Clips or straight pins for putting your pieces of fur together to hold in place when you run it through a machine or if you want to hand sew. I like to use Super 77 spray glue for attaching my ears to my ear base. So attaching the fur onto this, I'll actually have everything sewn together and then it'll be like a glove I slide over. And then I spray glue in here and then I press it down in order to give it its shape. Optional items, you can either hand sew with a needle and thread or you can use a sewing machine. It's really what you have on hand. You can also take a next step if you want to, you can get a pet shaver. This one here is an Andes, but I also recommend Oster shavers. They're really heavy duty, they're usually 2-speed, and I use a size 7 blade on it, so it's not too terribly short, so you don't have to worry about shaving down to the backing. I already went ahead and just quickly ran my slicker brush over all these fur pieces, just to remove all the loose fur so it's not in the way. One of the first things I'm going to want to do is actually take any one of these pieces that has darts in it, which I think is only 2 pieces, which is the very back of the ear, and pinch those together and sew those on the sewing machine real quick. And then I can really start putting all these other bigger pieces together. So what I like to do is I like to pinch it and then pull the fur out and use a slicker brush to remove any of the fur that might be in that little dart. So whenever you sew it, you don't have to worry about that fur being caught and then causing a bald spot. Now it's time for the fun part. Now, if you're worried about getting glue on your fingers, this stuff's not harmful in any way, except for if you spray this quite a bit, like I would say on a head or a larger project doing foam padding. I don't recommend doing it inside. It is an aerosol, so it can be very fumey, but since we're only doing ears, it's only very quick sprays. You can wear gloves if you're worried about getting the glue on your fingers, but it just kind of rolls off. It's almost like a spray contact cement. You gotta spray it on both sides. And here are the finished ears. If you have any questions at all, please comment below or send us an email at our website, dreamvisioncreations.com. If you like these videos, please hit the subscribe button and also hit that notification, and that way you'll be updated about the latest videos that we offer and also possible future live streams. Thank you all so much. Till next time. Bye.